Hi, I'm Sean Woods, Deputy Managing Editor of Rolling Stone Magazine. I'm sitting here with Contributing Editor David Kushner, who just wrote The Rise and Fall of a Bitcoin Kingpin.
Police in Japan have arrested Mark Capellas, the CEO of a failed Bitcoin company, over massive losses.
Dave, please talk about your story.
So Mark Capellas ran Mt. Gox, which was at the time the world's largest exchange for Bitcoin, and basically got it for nothing from another guy online in exchange for some return if they ever made money. And the crazy thing was is that they ended up making, he ended up making a lot of money on that site, and at one point they were trading like $4 million a month.
They became the biggest exchange for Bitcoin in the world.
Mt. Gox was very well known, also became very controversial. There were a series of high-profile hacks. And then what finally happened is that there was reported loss of over $500 million worth of Bitcoin. And that's the story that I went to explore.
Je peux pas imaginer une vie sans ordinateur là actuellement, c'est impossible.
You go and visit him, you find him in his Tokyo apartment, obviously he's been arrested once.
Yeah.
Another arrest is looming, investigations, yeah. Lawsuits, etc. And you find him at home baking. Describe
yes.
The scene at his house.
I went to his place and he had a train track. He was into model trains and he was kind of dismantling this from his table so that he could bake apple quiche. The guy is so serious about his apple quiche that there's old video on YouTube of him demonstrating how to cook this apple quiche.
Notre tarte est maintenant prête.
This is a person who's arguably moving some $500 million at some point.
Yes.
It's sitting on hundreds of millions of dollars at the very least, and he's obsessing about apple quiche.
Yes, but in a way, I mean, that kind of spoke to his character. I mean, I don't know, you try to put yourself in the shoes of these people, and you know, just imagine you take over something that started out, I mean, the site really started out as a place for people to trade Magic the Gathering, you know, trading cards, and you know, it's almost like someone says, here's my baseball card collection, why don't you sell them on the corner, and the next thing you know, you've got, you know, traffic jams and people lining up and mobsters and everybody wants the cards and the money. And he was now in the Wall Street Journal and Bloomberg TV is coming to interview him. And suddenly he's like, you know, the Wolf of Wall Street in a way. And he was ill prepared.
Is he in denial?
I don't know. I mean, he seemed, he definitely was a little worried about what was going to happen, but he kept maintaining his innocence. And he said, look, I know what I did. You know, there were times, certainly, when we left the apartment and we'd be walking around. I mean, there was a sense of him still looking over his shoulder to some degree.
Is he famous in Japan? Do people,
yes.
People know who he is?
Yes.
He's almost a mini celebrity.
Yes, he is a celebrity. In fact, we went out one time and it was clear that people knew who he was because he was, you know, this was big news there. I mean, not only was it the biggest heist kind of ever online, it was one of the biggest heists really of our time. One thing that's been a little surprising is that we haven't seen more people come out of the woodwork to say, I want my money back. Maybe they were using the money to do things that they shouldn't have been doing. I mean, you know, Mt. Gox was very, kind of rose to prominence during the time that Silk Road rose to prominence.
Mm-hmm.
But then this was a whole nother part of the story where you had the investigators into Silk Road had an eye on Mark Capellas, and it turns out they were actually exchanging some of the money. There were some corrupt bad cops who had stolen money during the Silk Road investigation who were exchanging it through Mt. Gox, and then they were going after Mt. Gox and Capellas to try to shut it down, presumably to erase traces of their misdeeds. So again, you know, this is a guy, this is a character who just was in the middle of this crazy shootout in this Wild West.
If he's at the center of that and he's at home baking apple quiche,
yeah.
Trying to perfect his recipe, I mean, this
right.
seems like he's not.
Seems odd. Yeah, and he was sitting there at one point, I was interviewing him, he had his cat on his lap. He was talking about I'm not Dr. Evil, so he was petting his cat on his lap, which he didn't see the irony of that. But I think this story is still unfolding to some degree. I mean, I've told the story, I mean, as close as we're gonna get as to what happened from his point of view and the sense of who this guy actually is. But I think that the investigation is still shaking out. We're certainly gonna find out more about what he did. We're gonna see where he winds up. And we may find out what happened to that missing money. We may never find out.